Thank you for joining me in the History of Science collections of the University of Oklahoma Libraries. Let's look at two books from the vault that throw light on the story of Aristotle. By almost any measure, Aristotle, a student of Plato and teacher of Alexander the Great, could be regarded as the most successful scientist ever to have lived. Many people regard Aristotle as a philosopher who got a lot wrong. But if science is the art of asking fruitful questions, more than just getting the right answer, then for almost any topic in natural science, Aristotle either started or invigorated a long-standing conversation. Areas of scientific inquiry which Aristotle set on a productive footing include biology, physics, cosmology, meteorology, geology, chemistry, logic, and metaphysics. This compilation of Aristotelian texts also includes commentaries and marginal notes, which will be of interest to a future reader. But to represent Aristotle's vast impact across all of the natural sciences, I would choose the first publication of Aristotle's biological works, printed in Venice in 1476. While Plato emphasized astronomy as the ennobling science, Aristotle insisted that biology, even the study of the lowliest organisms, is also a path to beauty, at least for one who understands the causes. For Aristotle, nature is an organism. So nature is known through the study of biology. In these works, Aristotle reports his observations of dissections of the dog shark. He perceptively studied bees and the incubation of birds' eggs. Some of Aristotle's observations were not replicated until modern times. Living beings for Aristotle were the paradigm examples of substance for his philosophy and lay at the theoretical foundation of his thought. In this book, leather tabs occur at the beginning of major sections in the book. Aristotle's biological works were numerous and amounted to over a fourth of his total works. This compilation of his biological works includes copious annotations by perhaps a dozen or more different readers, each with a distinctive form of handwriting. One can even see distinctive ways of drawing a pointing hand to highlight a line of text. Paleographic analysis of this book, a study of the handwriting, would create a profile of what each early modern reader found interesting and help us to understand the appeal and impact of Aristotle on biology in the decades after it was printed. Among both philosophers and historians, interest in Aristotle's biology remains vigorous today. Science is a story. What stories do you want to hear and tell about Aristotle?